Good morning, students. How are you?
Yesterday
We have finished here. I am going to start from the same slide again. I have told you that in 1987 elections were held in Jammu and Kashmir, and in that election National Conference and Congress, they were in alliance and they won the elections. But the people of Jammu and Kashmir, they knew this thing, that this is not the true victory of National Conference and Congress. According to them, the elections were rigged. And because of this, a popular resentment started in Jammu and Kashmir. The people of Jammu and Kashmir, they were very much tired with the undemocratic rule, with the interference of center, and they were also seeing this, that there is not being done anything for the development of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. So there became a political crisis in Jammu and Kashmir, and because of this political crisis, Jammu and Kashmir came in the grip of insurgency. In 1989, Jammu and Kashmir, as I have told you, came in the hands of militants. Now they wanted that Jammu and Kashmir should be separated from India. Not only separated from India, but it should be a separate nation. And students, I must tell you that these militants were getting moral support, material support, training, everything they were getting from Pakistan. Arms and arsenals, money, training, any type of support which they required, that was given to them by Pakistan. So by this, Jammu and Kashmir came in the grip of militants, those who wanted that Kashmir should be a independent nation that belonged to Kashmiri people only. And for a long time there was president rule, because the government was dismissed, because if there is no law and order in any of the state, then governor can use its power. And presidential rule is imposed in that state, that you have studied in class 11th also. So for a long time, this Jammu and Kashmir was under the president rule, and it was under the control of armed forces. Throughout the period from 1990, there was too much violence because of the militants and the fight between militants and army people. In 1996, elections were held. These are the three strands I have told you. They wanted separate nation, they want merger with Pakistan, and greater autonomy with Jammu to Jammu and Ladakh people. So these were. So, in 1996, elections were held there. National Conference won the election. Farooq Abdullah again became the Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, but he demanded greater autonomy. In 2002, again the elections were held, but this time National Conference did not won the election, and at that time PDP won the election, supported by Congress. PDP means People's Democratic Party. So there was coalition government. Mufti Muhammad became the chief minister for first 3 years, and after that Ghulam Nabi Azad became the chief minister because there was coalition there, and this was decided by both of them that they will become the chief minister according to their turn. In July 2008, president rule was imposed there. In November, December 2008, elections were held. Again, the coalition government was formed there by Umar Abdullah in 2009 again. And means there was no stable government. Sometimes there were president rule, sometimes there was government supported by Congress. Now in 2014, again the elections were held. And in 2014, highest voters turnout in last 25 years. Again, coalition government was formed there. Mufti Muhammad Saeed, supported by BJP. After his death, his daughter Mehbooba Mufti became the first woman chief minister in April 2016. Now, student, again in 2018, president rule was imposed because BJP has withdrawn its support. On 5th August 2019, this Article 370 was abolished by Narendra Modi's government. This we will discuss now. When Jammu and Kashmir was integrated in India, starting from that period, this Kashmir was a burning issue in India. And it was very much complicated because according to Article 370 and Article 35A, special status was given to Jammu and Kashmir. Many special powers were there. Means Jammu Kashmir can have its separate constitution, it can have its separate constituent assembly, its own flag, chief minister will be known as prime minister, governor will be known as Sadre Riyasat, and most of the union laws will not be implemented in Jammu and Kashmir. According to Article 35A, special citizenship rights were given to the people of Jammu and Kashmir, and those who are not living in Kashmir, they were not allowed to purchase property in Jammu and Kashmir. So these were the special status given to Jammu and Kashmir. And according to this, ek vidhan, ek nishan, ek pradhan, one flag, one head, one constitution, this was against this. Some people thought that Article 370 and Article 35A, they are constitutionally recognized separatism, means these are not according to the federal principles. These are against the unity of India. So, as I have told you, BJP-led NDA government, it has promised, it has its commitment that Kashmir will be fully integrated in India. It was a part of its election manifesto. When the elections were contested by BJP, in its manifesto, BJP has committed that if we will be in power, this Kashmir will be 100% a part of India, and Article 370 and Article 35A will be removed. So this government has presented the bill for Jammu and Kashmir reorganization on 5th August 2019 for the abolition of Article 370 and Article 35A. Firstly, it was presented in Rajya Sabha, it was passed, then it was again passed by Lok Sabha on 6th August, and on 9th August 2019, President of India has signed on this bill and Article 370 and 35A has been replaced, and Jammu and Kashmir got divided into two union territories. One is Ladakh and another one is Jammu and Kashmir. So now Jammu and Kashmir is not a state. In place of state, there are two union territories. One is Ladakh and another one is Jammu and Kashmir. So students, this was about Jammu and Kashmir. One thing I want to tell you, this the topic which I have taught you in this video and earlier two videos, this you will not found in your first chapter. Some part of these three videos you will found in 8th chapter, and this latest is not in the book, so you have to prepare the notes from these slides only. Okay, that's all for today, and tomorrow we will meet again with our next topic. Till then, goodbye, take care.